Did the UK get better conditions because they signed their contract earlier?
The UK vaccine contract was signed 3 months before the European agreement. So with the UK, we had 3 extra months to solve all the problems that we've come across.
That's false. While the British may have started the negotiations earlier, the EU signed its contract with AstraZeneca on August the 27th, one day before London inked its deal. So why has the EU suffered so many delays in its deliveries? It all comes down to the terms of the contract, where the UK drove a much harder bargain. First up, London demanded and got a priority clause. That means that AstraZeneca has to supply the UK first, even if it means stalling deliveries to other customers, like the EU. And the UK forced AstraZeneca to meet 5 separate delivery deadlines, while the EU only got a much less stringent best effort provisional clause. What's more, if AstraZeneca fails to meet the UK's deadlines, London was liable to demand compensation, a provision that Brussels did not put in its contract. The EU did manage to get a better price, €1.78 for each dose, while the UK paid €3.50. A price worth paying for the UK faced with a much higher death toll from the virus. And the EU did demand that AstraZeneca take legal responsibility for any negative side effects. That may seem wise given a tiny risk of blood clots, but that risk is still lower than that posed by COVID itself. All that means the UK is in champion form when it comes to vaccines, with over 30 million people already getting their jab. Meanwhile, the European vaccine rollout is only now beginning to pick up speed.